Hello everyone, in today's Roblox Studio tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to make a simple gem collection system where you can walk into diamonds or gems and collect them, and they'll have a nice spin animation and you will collect a gem inside of your leader stats. So let's get started. The first thing that you're going to want to do is click on your view tab and open up your output. This will be useful for displaying anything that's wrong with your code. And I just got an autosave, that's wonderful. Next, let's go back to our home over here. And let's open up your server script service and make sure they have a gem stat already inside of your leader stats. If not, I will have a little copy and pasting in the description for you to copy and paste this. Or you can just copy it quickly right now. Anyways, I'm going to close this. And now you need a gem model. I have one already saved inside my clipboard, so I just pasted this gem model in. Now I'm going to move it to a nice comfortable height. If you want, you can always find one from the toolbox. Or create your own. Perfect. Now let's get into coding the pickup functionality. So inside of here, let's press plus and add in a script. Let's rename the script to hit. The first thing that we're going to want to do inside of here is declare the part, which is part is going to be equal to script.parent. This will make it easier for coding later on when we're referring to the part. Next, we're going to go with our original position of the parts, or origin pause is going to be equal to the part, not pairs, part dot position. And then next we're going to do origin rotation, which is going to be equal to part dot orientation. And then we're going to go with local origin, and trans is going to be equal to origin trans is going to be equal to part dot transparency. And now we're going to add in a debounce, so local debounce is equal to false, just like that. Now let's create our actual function. So part not pairs, part dot touched is colon connect function, and then we're going to get what hit it, which is our hit. This is going to be what hit the thing. Anyways, now that we have this done, let's go and try getting the player from the part. Inside of here, what we're going to do is local PLR is equal to game colon get service player. Oh, that's not how I spell players. Players colon get player from character and hit dot parent, just like that. Next, we have to create an if statement. If PLR and debounce is equal to false, then what we do is we can set debounce to be equal to true, such as this doesn't run and it won't give the other player money, or it won't just continuously give the player money. So debounce equal to false, and now PLR dot leader stats dot gems, make sure gems is spelled exactly the same as it's spelled in leader stats, or else this won't work. And gems dot leader stats dot value plus equals 1 comma, let's create a little comment here, and let's do what this gives. I'm gonna do lowercase, gives the player gems. Now we're gonna create a for loop for I is equal to 1 comma 20. Do a quick wait over here so it doesn't instantly happen. Wait, and then we're going to do part dot orientation plus equals vector 3 dot new, and we're going to go with 5. Now yours may not actually be the same as this. For example, if we go inside of here, click on this, if you were to rotate it, you're rotating it on this however you want it to rotate, might not actually be this the y-axis. For example, it might be the z-axis or maybe even the x-axis. But for me, it's the y-axis. So I'm going to make sure to, I'm going to close that so I don't actually click there again. But for me, I'm going to do y-axis. So let's just call this rotation. And now we're going to go part dot position plus equals vector 3 dot new. And then we're going to go with 0, 0.1, 0. Now with this, we're just gonna do this rise. We're just gonna make the part rise. If you want to go some other way, then change these other values. Next we're gonna do is part dot transparency plus equals 0.25. If you want, you can also just do 0.025, but I like doing putting a 0 in there just because it looks a bit more clean. And just like that, we have our main animation done. So let's just do fade. And now we can reset our part. After we do a quick wait, 5 seconds. Let's set this wait until part reappears. And then we just go with, you can just copy and paste this. Part.orientation is equal to origin rotation. Part.position, we can quickly copy this little line, is equal to origin position. And then we just go part.transparency, copy that, is equal to origin transparency. And then we can go debounce is equal to false. Now this should work nicely and everything should nicely animate. So we can go into our studios, click over here, play. And then as you should see, we walk into this, it goes up and away and we get one gem. And if we wait 5 seconds, it pops up and we could do the same thing. Now all you have to do is find an animation that you like, and then just copy this thing around the place, just like this. And just place it around, and just like that we have a whole bunch of gems. Although you'd probably want to do this for your whole map and put them in areas. So now you can just walk into them, they'll play a nice animation, and they'll fade away and reappear. Hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial. This has been my first tutorial in a couple of months now, so I'm a bit rusty at recording, but hopefully you have found this video helpful, and subscribe, and thank you for reaching 1,000 subscribers. I did not expect that to ever happen, but here we are, 1,000 subscribers. I think I reset like 2 days ago or a day ago since the time of this recording. Anyways, thank you so much, and I'll see you in another video.